I can't really remember the last time I had a chance to go in the backyard and just run around.
School's just so much pressure that every day I would wake up dreading it.
I'm afraid that our children are going to sue us for stealing their childhoods.
This is my last Olympic assignment, so after this, I'm going to go to sleep.
Yeah.
Because I don't stress out about math. Well, how do you manage it?
Do they have to kill me or something?
I should do what they assign me and try to get it just completed as fast as possible.
Okay. Well, I understand. I mean,
it's a state of mind. Some people come up, some people don't.
For these exams, for these, for these major projects that I have in American Studies, that there's always so much more time that I could put into it. That, I purposely get ahead on my work to work on them. And then it becomes, kind of this endless cycle of, all right, I gotta get all this work done by this time so I can spend how many hours working on this project and how many hours studying for this AP and whatever,
I do it, yeah.
I mean, I do it. What else do you want me to do? Do the next day?
No, not at all.
I just do it. I'm okay, I'm going to spend 45 minutes on this. Do the best as I can. I don't work myself up on my homework. I don't think none of it is too stressful.
And you can finish it in 45 minutes?
Yeah.
Outlier. Yeah.
You stress about the other subjects and you waste time stressing about all the other subjects.
See, that's why you don't think about the other subjects. You finish them first and you're okay, what else should I do?
Yeah.
That is good advice. I mean,
it's really hard to do that when you're
The best advice is don't take yourself on the foot. It's hard to follow.
Yeah. It's really hard to take a chill pill, as you put it. When you have to do film a video for Chinese, you have homework for French and English, which involves writing an essay, and all this stuff, and you just don't have time.
Colleges have this overwhelmingly high expectation of you that you're somehow supposed to juggle your grade point average, but at the same time, challenge yourself. So it's they expect you to know exactly where your limits are, to the point where you can excel, but you're also showing them that you have an interest.
And they're changing it now so that you can take 10 AP as your first experience chemistry, which is really stupid, because you're not getting as much out of it. They're teaching it towards the AP, so it's an easier course. And they're teaching it to the test. And it's not a course that you're taking anymore because you like chemistry, you've done it before and you want to keep doing it. You're doing it because, you're a sophomore and you want to be that sophomore to take your sophomore. And
that's what I'm trying to say. You know,
but you don't.
Yeah, I think that, in addition to that, I think students should want to be that person to take the AP. So it's not so much that they're interested, but they just want to take it, and then that's where they're pressing. I try, because I am interested in taking Arabic and, doing art and whatever. The thing is, this is high school, so I'm not going to, kill myself unnecessarily, by, doing art or, doing more tasks. It's, I'm going to do this because I like French. History is fun for me. That's not even much of a task. And so it's, I do want to take Arabic, but I'm not going to because I know that'd be another little longer that I am not willing to do.
Alone.